Now the topic is, can we prevent cancer? So the question is, if we can prevent cancer, whether it is a 5%, 3%, 4%, 10%, 20%, how much is preventable? So then the question comes, the preventable cancer and not preventable cancer, which is in our hand to prevent. The first thing for any kind of disease which is not possible to prevent is because of a simple basic thing, is that we can't choose our parents. So the genetical part we cannot change. So in case of different diseases, different statistics will be there. But in case of cancer, the statistics is 10% only part is due to genetics. So 90% is because of us, the cancer is troubling us. That means it is because of environment, because of surrounding, because of lifestyle, because of so many other cancer-causing chemicals, which are, in technical term, called as carcinogens. So cancer-causing carcinogens. So these carcinogens are there. But the number one in all this is tobacco. Then there are many other things. So before going to it, actual slides, there may be some slides may not have been prepared, but at the thinking process, I thought of giving this information maybe in the morning when I was just preparing it. So I have not made few slides, but the whole thing is, you take home message. What take home message you can carry by listening this talk? You must have spent so much of time to come and visit and hear the lecture. Then there should be something which you can carry, you can tell to your neighbors, your friends. And in this prevention of cancer, you can contribute for yourself and for others. So this contribution is possible by tobacco is number one. Asbestos is number two. I was reading, there was a very good book on prevention of cancer in this library. So asbestos is also a cause of occupational cancers. The other thing which easily could be controlled, and that is the food colors. Food colors are added in jalebi or some other. The where we can avoid is when we order, when we visit a hotel, we order for some kind of, suppose, a spinach preparation, a palak preparation, or maybe even the non-veg vegetarian stuff. There we find the colors which are toxic. Not only toxic, they may be carcinogenic, they may cause cancer. So whenever generally you order for any dish from the restaurants for a food, you try to mention it. The first thing is, as we will see, the less of oil and also no colors required. Then he will repeatedly ask you that, saab, ye to color dal ke hi aaya hai, what we can do and all that. You have to tell him, prepare special thing for me. I don't want color. You don't have to spend color in this. And this is very, very important from the point of view, because since my childhood, I used to go into the market during the festival time and bring the color which was possible in the gross in the shops. I used to go and get it. So those, that kind of a color used to come maybe even less than a few 10 paise. So the color comes and we used to add it in making a different kind of sweets, especially the Srikhand, a very popular dish in Maharashtra. So this is definitely a damaging thing. But I recollected it only when I became a cancer scientist in Tata Memorial Center. So what is happening in that? That particular color is nowadays, chances are there that it is not available. It is banned also. It is a metallic yellow color. But by just eating once, you are not going to get a cancer. It takes time. And as at an introduction, just to give you the idea, the time required to cause a cancer, especially in the food colors additives, is not less than 20 years. So it's a long duration. So one can't say ki yesterday I had taken it the palak and that was a color one, so I started thinking. The best thing is avoid worry, but improve upon it and don't buy such things. So this is very, very important. Not only that, the fried oil, this is the only one more caution as a takeover message, and then we'll start with the lecture. If the oil is fried, first thing is a deep fried is bad because it generates the chemicals which are in the wrong run may cause cancer. Especially the important message, if deep fried is not to be avoided, it's not possible or whatever the reason, at least once it is fried, you don't keep on boiling it again and again. Whole day, entire day, then in the evening also, again boiling it, not to waste that whatever is remaining. You have to just boil whatever frying process is there, do it only once only. First thing, avoid if possible. If not, don't keep on heating it. Heating it makes it more harmful. Okay. Now the meaning of prevention, there are two things. In prevention and the control, avoid, prevention, control, different terms. But different meanings are there. Avoid and prevention, there is not much difference. But definitely there is a difference between a control and prevention. The cancer prevention is not a synonymous with cancer control. It's not the same. Prevention and control is not the same. Why? Cancer control considers early diagnosis. Control means early diagnosis. If it is done early, tomorrow, if the early diagnosis of prostate cancer or breast cancer is carried out, then naturally what will happen? The patient will respond well and may not even die. So survival will increase, and survival leads to a cure. And in a technical term, the cure limit has been changed. Once upon a time, 10-15 years ago, if I had to give a lecture, I would have said cancer cure means a patient when he survives for 5 years. Five years. Now it is entire life. I am 62. But if a time frame is made that one should, can live for 70, then the entire up to 62 to 70, I must get a life. Then only I will be called a cure if I get a cancer. If a person gets a cancer at the age of 30, the earlier landmark was 5 years. 5 years is cure. With after 35 years, if we die, the statistics will say, yes, we have cure. Because at the curing was difficult. But during that particular cancer conference at Tata Memorial Center, I was present. And then the objection was raised. Why? The person has got an entire life. Up to 60, he would have retired. He would have given something. Why 5 years? So it should be the entire life. The average life cycle one should be able to enjoy. That is called ideally a cure. So early detection will help in the curing of the patient. Cancer control considers early diagnosis. The prevention means its avoidance in any form, early or late. And this particular report is from Raven and Rowe Prevention Cancer, London, 1967. He has written a book on prevention of cancer in 1967. In that particular book, where I got that reference, he had, but this particular book I am not able to get, but the reference is a quoted reference from Dr. Manu Kothari and Dr. Luke Mehta. They have written the book, The Nature of Cancer, in the 1973. So in that particular book, the mention is made about cancer prevention. So cancer prevention is totally avoidance of cancer. Today we will talk about cancer prevention as well as the cancer control together. But major emphasis will be on the cancer prevention. Now what the World Health Organization states, says tobacco use and exposure causes 1.5 million cancer deaths annually. So tobacco use makes 15 lakhs death annually, and chronic hepatitis B virus causes, it's a kind of a jaundice, where the liver cancer death is 3,40,000 people annually in the world. And this is more prevalent in case of China. So simple way to prevent it is just vaccination. So vaccination for Australia antigen or vaccination for hepatitis, everybody knows about it, hepatitis B, kind of a jaundice. There are two jaundices. One is hepatitis A and hepatitis B. But hepatitis B causes as cancer. Hepatitis A has no relation with the cancer. So this could be done. Another thing I told you, asbestos, according to WHO, is one of the main occupational cancer. The first occupational cancer story, I will just tell you, this was way back in 18th century, when there were the boys age 12 to 14, they used to clean the chimney, and these chimney sweepers got a scrotal cancer. So this is the first report about the occupational cancer in the world. And then it was banned of doing this, because they used to tie that particular these boys, and they used to enter into the chimney and clean it. And by cleaning it, they got a scrotal cancer. Now this is a list which is based on the cancer incidence and mortality in by Tata Memorial Cancer Society. They have done it. In the year 2002 and 2004, this is the latest report, which says that tobacco-related cancers, so look at the tobacco-related cancer, it is because in the lip, tongue, oral cavity, pharynx, esophagus, that is a food pipe, larynx, lung, urinary bladder, and total related cancer is 5,806 in case of males. In case of females is 2,210. Why this difference? It is also tobacco related. But women, they don't smoke. So again, smoking hazard is tremendous. One can notice from this. And another thing is important to note that the lung cancer, 1,154, whereas lung cancer estimated number in female is 435. This number is also less in case of females. Now this is the fact of, from the lung cancer, the facts. This is very interesting to note that the lung cancer annual number of deaths per 100,000 population, per 100,000 population was counted since 1917-18. So 1918, you look at the figure, it is lesser than the 50, a very small amount. But later on what happened? The people started smoking, and then the lung cancer incidence increased. So this is 1956-59. Still.